Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at what's new in Mac OS X Yosemite. So before I get into what's new, I just wanted to tell you about the new video guide to Yosemite. And this is the fourth edition of the video guide series that I've done. Instead of writing a book on how to use Mac, what I've done is create a series of videos and packaged it up as a Mac app. And you can get this in the Mac App Store. And it's broken up by chapter, and you can select a chapter and then you could play it or scrub through it. You can jump around to any chapter and any part that you want and learn how to use the basics of using your Mac and using Yosemite. So check that out. So let's start by looking at Notification Center. It comes out from the right just like before, but now you have Today and Notifications, two separate tabs. It's the same as iOS 8. Notifications is what you had before, just a list of all the most recent notifications from different apps. Today, though, gives you a lot of cool information, like, for instance, there's a stocks widget, weather widget, there's a calculator right there, as well as things like calendar events and reminders, the date, things like that. Now, you can add more to this by clicking the edit button at the bottom, and you could see more items to add. For instance, I can add world clock here. You can also go to System Preferences, and in System Preferences you can go to a new extensions pane, and this is where you add extensions, like for instance the things that could appear there as widgets in the Notification Center. Another major overhaul is Spotlight Menu. Now, Spotlight Menu appears here just as before, or you can use Command Space to open it. Right away you'll see it's called Spotlight Search, and it appears in the middle of the screen instead of at the upper right. You can use it to do all the similar things you could do before, plus a lot more. So for instance, you could start typing the name of a file, and it will find it either by file name or the contents. But notice there's a nice preview window here on the right where you can preview images, text and documents, things like that. In addition, it finds a whole bunch of other stuff. For instance, it'll search Wikipedia and put it here, and you can click there to go to the article. So Safari also looks a little bit different. Matter of fact, it looks very close to using Safari on the iPad now. When you start a new window or new tab, you can certainly use top sites as before, but you also can have this favorites view here where it basically can replace your favorites toolbar, because whenever you bring up a new tab or new window, you can simply select where you want to go. But you still have the option of bringing up the favorites bar there. You also have the left sidebar here, which allows you to look at bookmarks and your reading list and then other things, including subscriptions. We're going to have both subscriptions now in Safari for iOS and Yosemite, and I'll be showing that in a future video. And you've got a new tab view here as well. So one of the apps that can accept extensions is Mail, and an extension that comes with Yosemite is the ability to annotate images and PDFs. So here I've got a new email I'm composing. I've attached an image, and I can select markup here from this button, and now I can draw on it. I can add a signature, I can add text, I can add boxes. The Calendars app now has a new look, which includes a day view here, which can be very useful. And also notice the icon here for FaceTime now has a little phone in it. That's because FaceTime and Messages in Yosemite work with iOS 8 to allow you to use your iPhone to send, first of all, SMS messages. So you get an SMS message from a non-iPhone user, and your iPhone will send it to your Mac using Yosemite, and you can actually respond using the Messages app. Likewise, the same works with audio. You can actually use the FaceTime app here to receive audio phone calls, regular phone calls. Somebody calls you on your iPhone, it's sitting on your desk and your Mac's there too. You can actually use your Mac to talk to them rather than picking up the iPhone. Now here's what I think may be the biggest new feature for a lot of users in Yosemite: iCloud Drive. So I'm in the Finder here and I'm looking at my Documents folder, but I'm going to switch over to iCloud Drive. So you notice here there's the Keynote Numbers pages and a Text Edit folder. These are the folders that you had before with iCloud, but you never actually could see them. You have to run Keynote and open a document in Keynote or save one in Keynote to be able to access the Keynote portion of your iCloud Drive. Now you can actually see them here in the Finder. And any app you use that's iCloud Documents enabled will create a special folder for itself here. but you have complete access to the iCloud Drive, and in fact you can create your own folders in here, drag and drop your own files in here, and it works a lot like a Dropbox or a similar service like that. You can put any files you want and they will sync across your Macs and you'll be able to access those files from anywhere. So there are a few more crossover features between iOS 8 and Yosemite. One is AirDrop. You'll be able to AirDrop some files between iOS devices and your Mac. Of course, yeah, you need an app on iOS 8 to be able to handle the file, so text edit presumably still won't work, but say Pages documents would work. Also, you've got the ability to do handoff, which means you can start composing an email on your Mac and pick it up on your iPhone or iPad, or go from one of those iOS devices in the middle of composing an email and pick it up on your Mac. And it works with other apps as well, like Safari. You could be browsing one page and then pick it up on the other device. And of course, finally, I should mention the design changes. You see there's a new main font. There's some new icons here in the sidebar. The dock looks very different and very two-dimensional. And one of the biggest design changes is how the red, yellow, and green buttons work. Gone is the maximize type button here, which a lot of people just never used or didn't understand how to use. And you have the close and go to the dock button, the same as before, but now the green button takes an app or a window full screen. So it works as full screen did before, except instead of having the full screen button at the upper right, it's now the green button here. So a lot of cool design changes, feels new, and it feels pretty fresh. So there's a quick overview of the new features in Yosemite. And once again, I love it if you check out my video guide to Yosemite, available in the Mac App Store. Thanks.